everyone, Jason here. Halloween is coming up, and just like in previous years, I wanted to build a machine to throw sugar around. This year I decided to build it using the Boost, and before I show you how it all works, I have created building instructions for it, which you can find over at jkbrickworks.com, as well as information on how to program it. All of the pieces you need to build this come in the Boost Creative Toolkit, so you don't need any other pieces. The only other thing you need is some kind of ammunition, and in this case, much like previous years, I'm using these mini chocolates, which are readily available in Canada this time of year. But really, you can use anything about the same size that fits on the conveyor belt and fits in the launch tray here. So how does it all work? The chocolates are all queued up on the conveyor belt at the top, which is driven by the external motor. And I have the wire routed through this bracket in the back to keep it out of the way. And when we start the sequence, we just activate the motor for a little bit to drop a candy off the front of the conveyor belt onto the launch tray. The launch tray is at one end of this spinning armature, and on the other end, I have these tires to balance out the weight of the tray and the chocolate. And that way it can spin nice and smoothly at speed without causing too much wobble in the machine. Normally the armature is driven by one of the internal motors of the hub, but I've just removed this gear temporarily so that I can spin it manually to show you what is going on. Now, the reason I designed it this way is that in order to launch something even as small as one of these mini chocolates, it actually takes quite a bit of energy to be applied almost instantaneously to get it to go any reasonable amount of distance. And that's something that's really hard to do with Lego motors. They're just not designed for that. But we can use a Lego motor to get this armature to spin quite fast. And it doesn't really matter how long it takes to get the armature spinning up to speed. It could take a quarter of a second or half a second. But once it is spinning at speed, we have access to all of this rotational kinetic energy to launch the chocolate. So how do we do that? If we take a look at the launch tray, I have built in these two L-shaped lift arms that are hinged at the front. And the bottom of the L's drop down below the tray so that as the armature is rotating, if we introduce something into the path of those lift arms, they will lever up at the rotation point and launch whatever is sitting in the tray. And to do that, we have this small arm here driven by the other internal motor of the hub that can be raised and lowered. And when it's up, it is right in the path of those lift arms. Now, the only other thing left to do after we launch a chocolate is to bring the launch tray back under the conveyor belt. And to do that, we're using the light slash color sensor here. And we just rotate the armature until it sees the blue under the launch tray, and then it stops it. And that is about all there is to it. I do want to give a shout out to my brother who helped me work out some of the kinks in the design. We had a lot of fun a couple of weekends ago throwing mini chocolates around. As always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I'll see you next week when we take a look at this beautiful new set.